Welcome back. This is Jack Ivey Broadcasting, TV 12 and TV 97. This is your JV action between the Lady Braves and the Lady Cardinals. And first up to bat for the Lady Cardinals, we have... We have number 27. This is Maylee Holt playing out in center field today. The pitch was a strike. She swings. We've got Madeline Booker for the Lady Braves on the hump today, with Emma Glover as the catcher. Brings the count to 1-1. The pitch is a ball outside. The count will be 2-1. That pitch is fouled up, and it is caught by the third baseman. That is Kelly Brooke Morgan.
Now for bat number 13, Caitlin Cole.
For the Lady Braves, and that's one out. Next up to bat for your Lady Cardinals is your second baseman, Caitlin Coley. First pitch is a ball, that's high. Be one ball, no strikes, with one out here in the top of the first inning. That's foul ball. It evens the count out, 1-1. Strike brings the count to 1-2 with one out here in the top of the first inning. Ball high evens the count to 2-2. Ball inside and low. That brings it to full count. There's your pitcher, Madeline Booker, number 17.
You tell them you got a world famous camera down
there. That's a strikeout for Madeline Booker. That'll be.
Now for that.
Let's see. That'll be.
Right.
It'll be a strikeout on Caitlin Coley. And that'll be the second out. Here I am. We're not looking good on this side. We're looking good on that side. There we go. The bunt is foul by Presley Ross. Brings the count to 0-1. I've got a guy, I don't know if y'all have ever heard of him on the camera here. The world famous Jack Ivey.
First night on the camera. Right?
First night on the camera?
No. I wish. We're going to get.
Ball's fouled back.
We're going to get Miss Holly on the camera next. Hey, you can put her on the phone.
Brings the count to 0-2 with two outs. Here in the top of the first inning for Madeline Booker. Third pitch strikeout, that's two strikeouts for Madeline Booker in the inning. This broadcast is brought to you by McRide Insurance, 9 3rd Street in Belmont, payment office at 1407 Battleground Drive in Iuka, under the leadership of Tamara and Brandon Farr, 662-454-7831. Nunley Trucking, Herman and Daryl Nunley and staff, 662-424-0080. Good luck to our Chishmingo County teams. Tiffin Motorhomes, Red Bay, Belmont, and Iuka, featuring Allegro Homes. Good luck to all of our local teams. Belmont Medical Clinic, for the best medical care for you and your family. Remember, Heather Edmondson and the staff at Belmont Medical Clinic. For an appointment, call 662-454-3401. JR's Wholesale and Boutique is your bargain headquarters, located on Old Highway 25. And phone us at 662-424-1242. See us for jeans for men and women at great prices. Household and cleaning supplies, tools, grocery items. Our inventory is changing daily at JR's Wholesale and Boutique in Iuka. Plaza Lane's Premier Bowling Alley in Corinth, Mississippi. 2001 East Shiloh Road, we are your party headquarters. Coming soon, new arcade equipment featuring full-service cafe, arcade, and billiards. Full-service pro shop for all of your bowling equipment needs. And leagues for all skill levels. Your perfect birthday party destination. Call us at 286-8105 or visit us online at bowlcorinth.com. There's more to life than bowling, but not much. We'll be back here in the bottom of the first inning with Madeline Booker, your pitcher,
Madeline Booker,
up to bat first for the Lady Braves. And that will be number 15. That's Aubrey Scott pitching for the Lady Cardinals. First pitch is a ball, brings the count to 1-0. Strike one.
Cool.
Yeah. There's Aubrey Scott, your pitcher for the Lady Cardinals. The count is even at 1-1 with no outs for Madeline Booker. Hit past the second baseman into center field as she rounds first over to second, and she is out. Good play there by the Cardinals. Get the tag down, and that will be out number one.
Now for bat number 8, Sarah Methvin.
That will bring up number 8, Sarah Methvin. She is playing in center field today for the JV Lady Braves. Yep, two center fielder, and not center fielder, the second baseman that was caught. That'll be an out. So two outs for the Lady Braves. And next up to bat will be Kelly Brooke Morgan.
Now to bat.
Playing over at third base.
Kelly Brooke Morgan.
Pitch one is a strike. I'll bring the count to 0-1 with two outs here in the bottom of the first inning. No runs scored for either team so far. That ball is fouled behind the Belmont dugout here. Over towards the third base side. Did I say third base? I meant first base side. I said third base side. But third pitch is outside, and that'll be ball one. Bring the count to 1-2.
They don't teach that to your junior year.
Oh, yeah.
Right. They teach first and third, junior year.
And the pitch is down. That is a ball. Brings the count, evens the count to 2-2 with two outs here in the bottom of the first inning. This is number 13, Kelly Brooke Morgan, up to bat with Aubrey Scott on the mound. That is a swinging pitch, swinging strike for strike three. And that will be a strikeout for Kelly Brooke Morgan as we go into the top of the first inning. This broadcast is brought to you by Dollar Wise Discount Grocery in Burnsville. Owners Ted and Wendy Sparks, name brand appliances and mattresses, Dollar Wise and Shopping Center in Burnsville. Triple D's Bucket Service, Barney, Brandon, and Dustin Dick will try their best to meet all of your high-reach needs, whether trimming or removing a tree, debris removal, stump grinding, or cleaning a steeple. All are done in a professional manner. Licensed, bonded, and insured. Call 662-279-7500. Thompson Gas, the most trusted name in propane, locally owned, 256-356-2194. Dustin Chase Oliver, your new hometown manager. Call and ask for the Rely propane meter with Thompson Gas today. No more tank rent, no more fees, no more large propane bills, no more calling to fill tank, just pay only for what you use or burn monthly. Budget friendly while keeping your tank full. Free meter installation. We also have a referral program for you to make money for referring someone you know to use as well. 256-383-9421. Got someone you take care of or someone elderly or handicapped who can't read the gauge or call for gas? Rely is the answer. Thompson will put you at ease with Rely. Tishomingo Auto Repair, located at 1202 Highway 25 in Tishomingo, open Monday through Saturday, 8 to 5. Call us for your auto repair needs at 662-438-6650. That is strike one for Madeline Booker. Up to bat, we have number 24, that is Atlee Scott, for the Lady Cardinals. That ball is fouled back. That brings the count to 0-2. This is JV action following your varsity game that started around 5 p.m. That is another strikeout for Madeline Booker, making that 3 on the day so far. Your varsity Lady Braves took the win 2-0 over the Lady Cardinals here for senior night for the Lady Braves. Now up to bat is shortstop Lily Sparks. Pitch one is high, and that brings the count to 1-0. Foul ball, evens the count out, 1-1 for Lily Sparks. That's ball 2, and brings the count to 2-1. A little low and inside. Hit up the middle, fielded by the shortstop. Over to first, is past first baseman. She rounds, going to second, and she will be safe at second with a single and an error charged in the field. Will lead her to second base.
Next up the bat, number 10, Molly Cole.
That'll be the first hit for the Lady Cardinals. And first pitch will be a strike for Molly Coley, playing over in right field today. Strike the bunt. That will be strike number 2. Ball low and inside. It brings the count to 1-2. with Madeline Booker on the mound, and Molly Coley up to bat, playing out in right field today. On deck, we have Maggie Owens playing in left field. We have a time called on the field. Tying the shoelace out in center field. And we'll get back to action here in the top of the second inning. The 1-2 count with one out. That's strike three, and that will be the fourth strikeout for your pitcher, Madeline Booker.
Bat number 30, Maggie Owens.
Maggie Owens will now come up to bat, playing left field today. Pitch one is a strike. That brings the count to 0-2 with two outs here in the top of the second inning. No runs scored for either team. And fouled back behind the backstop. Keeps the count at 0-2. Ball two as the catcher goes and is safe at third base. That brings the count to 1-2. As runner advances to third base. Guess I better update the inning here. We've still got it on first inning. This is the top of the second inning. That is strike three, and that will be the fifth strikeout for your pitcher for the Lady Braves, Madeline Booker. Good luck to our Tishomingo County teams from your circuit court clerk, Rebecca Oaks. Need a winning financial strategy? Visit Guaranty Bank, formerly First American National Bank, for personalized banking solutions tailored to your needs. Looking for a bank that's on your team? Guaranty Bank is ready to help you reach your financial goals. Whether you're saving for a rainy day or planning for the future, Guaranty Bank has the financial tools you need to win. Guaranty Bank is proud to be your community bank with friendly service and familiar faces. Sid Whitehurst owner, phone number is 424-0025. Sid has a second location to serve you at 617 Highway 72, just past Tishomingo County High School. Call us at 662-205-6469. We have Coyote Tractors and Skag Mowers. Sid Whitehurst, the owner. Now is the time to get that new mower. Prices have never been better. The selections are great. Bush Hog zero-turn mowers are dependable and solid. They're offered in the state, commercial, and professional series. Whether you're a lawn care professional who requires productivity, dependability in your machine, or a homeowner who wants professional results in a fraction of the time, smile. Bush Hog has the mower to meet your needs. So if you've got a Bush Hog mow or dig, get her did at Sid's. Johnny's Four Wheelers and Mowers, military family-owned business. Owner works on and services merchandise. Dealer for Argo, Bad Boy, Bighorn, Bobcat, County Clipper, Coolster, Dixie Chopper, Massimo Motor, and Spartan. We have zero-turn mowers, side-by-side, adult and kids four-wheelers, pontoon boats, golf carts, and more located at Highway 19 in Red Bay, 256-919-1804. Now up to bat for the Lady Braves, we have... We have number six, this is Lexi Massengill, playing over in right field today. Pitch one is a ball, and that brings the count to 1-0 here in the bottom of the second inning. 2-0 is the count. We've got Aubrey Scott pitching for the JV Lady Cardinals. Foul down the first base side, and that brings the count to 2-1 with no outs here in the bottom of the second inning. Mm-hmm. There's another foul ball, this time down the third base side. That evens the count to 2-2. Jack's doing a pretty good job over here on the camera. World-famous Jack Ivey. I'm Matthew Willis, bringing the call here for the JV Lady Braves versus Lady Cardinals softball game. Tomorrow I'll be with David in Kossuth, bringing the Tisch County versus Kossuth baseball. And Lexi will be hit by the pitch, and she will go over to first base.
Next up to bat, number 25, Chloe Cook.
Yeah, Scott Webster will be here bringing your Tisch County softball. I'll be over in Kossuth with David Leatherwood bringing your Tisch County baseball. You don't be anywhere. And Jack will be bringing your Red Bay versus Winston County, you say softball? Softball? First pitch is a ball, and that will advance Lexi over to second base. Up to bat now for your Lady Braves is Chloe Cook. She's playing in shortstop today for your JV action. This ball brings the count to 2-0. Around 5 p.m., me and Jack had the Tisch County versus Belmont varsity game. Tisch County took the win 2-0 in what was very much a pitcher's duel. Seen lots of strikeouts and two great performances by both pitchers. It's 3-0 count. I believe she's going to take this one regardless. Now she's worked her way into a hitter's count. This is 3-1 for Chloe Cook, your shortstop. And ball four, and now we have runners at first and second.
Next up to bat, number 15, Emma Glover.
Next up to bat is your catcher, Emma Glover, for the Lady Braves, with runners on first and second, and no outs here in the bottom of the second inning. Signs a bunt, and it is foul ball. Count goes to 0-1 for your catcher, Emma Glover. Pitch on the way from Aubrey Scott. That is strike number 2. Brings count to 0-2 with no outs here in the bottom of the second inning. Jack, have you watched any women's college basketball here lately? And she brings a bunt. That's fair. And first baseman bobbles it, and she is safe. We now have bases loaded with no outs for the Lady Braves here in the bottom of the second inning. You did watch some women's college basketball? Well, I'm sure you've seen Caitlin Clark. She was drafted first pick overall in the WNBA draft tonight.
She did?
Yeah, first overall.
Would you pick her or Reese?
I don't know. Caitlin Clark versus Reese Moore. That would be a great matchup. Next we have Madison Daly. She is your second baseman today for the JV Lady Braves.
Who was your pick in the WNBA?
No foul ball, and that brings the count to 0-2.
I don't want the troublemaker Reese. LSU.
Your second baseman Madison Daly has bases loaded here with 0-2 count and no outs. And that's a ball. Brings the count to 1-2. That pitch is high and outside. That evens the count at 2-2. Aubrey Scott has definitely got her work cut out for her. She's got bases loaded and no outs here in the bottom of the second inning. Pitch is low and outside. That is a full count for Madison Daly. And that pitch walks in a run for the Lady Braves.
Now batting, okay. Number 21, Ainsley Robertson.
Sonic and Belmont and Iuka is your morning drink stop. Large soft drink starting at 99 cents. Happy hours 2 to 4 p.m. daily. Half price soft drinks, slushies, and teas. Download the Sonic app or place your order online. Nope, that definitely wasn't yet. Shoot, this ain't right. Now up to bat for your Lady Braves is Ansley Robertson playing over at first base. It's a 2-0 count here with no outs and bases loaded for your Lady Braves. Time is called, so all of the runners will go back to their base.
The umpire kicked the ball.
Oh, the umpire kicked the ball? Okay.
By accident.
So that'll be a dead ball, and all the runners will go back. We have Ansley Robertson here with a 3-0 count. And Aubrey Scott works back in with a strike. Yeah, Ansley. Ansley played for Belmont last year and now is playing for the Braves this year. A 3-1 count. And ball four, walks another run.
She'll try to tell you she's coming down.
She will?
Yeah.
Well.
Now batting number 17, Madeline Booker.
I don't know why she tell you she's kin to you. If I was, I wouldn't tell anybody. You know that.
I said it where nobody could hear it.
That ball is hit over towards right field, but it will go foul. That'll bring the count to 0-1. Still have our track meet going on over here with an assortment of 1A teams from across the state on our campus as Tishomingo County hosts a variety of track meets throughout the year and postseason. Pitch is a strike, and that brings the count to 0-2. As Aubrey Scott works to get her first, to try to get her first out of the inning here. She's got bases loaded with no outs. And that ball is hit to the second baseman, and that will be the first out of the inning for the Lady Cardinals.
Now batting number 8,
but does bring
Sarah
in a run.
Methvin.
So next up to bat for the Lady Braves will be Sarah Methvin playing over in center field today. She takes the plate with bases loaded. Or no, not bases loaded. Runners on second and third and one out. Hits over to the shortstop. Unable to make the grab, and Methvin will go over to second base. But not before scoring a run.
Now
and we'll bring the score
13,
to 4-0 for the Lady Braves. Back up is Kelly Brooke Morgan, playing third base for the JV Braves this afternoon. First pitch is a ball. Strike one swinging, evens the count to 1-1 with one out, and runners on second and third for the Lady Braves. The Braves have a 4-0 advantage right here in the bottom of the second inning. And fouled back here behind home plate. That'll bring the count to 1-2 for Kelly Brook Morgan. Strike 3, swinging for Kelly Brook Morgan.
Now batting number 6.
He gives Aubrey Scott her second strikeout of the day. And 2 outs here in the bottom of the second inning for the Lady Cardinals. Next up to bat for the Lady Braves is Lexi Massengill, playing in right field. And that ball is hit into the gap between center and left field. And that will score 2 runs for Lexi Massengill as she is safe at second with the double. Econo Storage, only climate control storage in the area. Owner, Haskell Sparks, located in Belmont and Tishomingo. 423-8767. Oh. She got that out. So they scored 1 run and makes the score 5-0. Brought to you by Best Way Incorporated in Golden, Mississippi. Stop by and visit them today for all your safety, chemical, janitorial, and traffic control needs. Need a sign or banner for your business or your athlete? They manufacture them in-house to suit whatever you or whatever need you have. Locally owned and operated for over 40 years with an experienced, friendly staff to assist you. The Tishomingo County School Board and Superintendent Christy Holly would like to wish TCHS and Belmont Schools a great school year. Good luck to all of our Tishomingo County teams. Tri-State Insurance Agents, Kim Wells, Caleb Wells, Mike Moore, Christy Mayo, and Brenda Purser, located in Belmont and Red Bay. Call us in Belmont at 662-454-3304 or in Red Bay at 256-356-4804. When you become a customer of ours, you become family. We will take the uncertainty out of insurance and make sure you have the protection you need. Whether it be insuring your vehicle, home, motorcycle, four-wheeler, boat, RV, farm, or business, we have a policy that can be tailored for you. We are licensed in Mississippi, Alabama, and Tennessee. Happy Hollow Outdoors, we carry a large variety of gifts, seasonal gifts, baby gifts, items for pets, women's boutique clothing, interior items. We have a bridal and baby gift registry in the sporting goods section. We offer camo and hunting apparel. Now up to bat for the Lady Cardinals is Haley Carruthers, your designated player for
Haley Carruthers.
Carruthers, yeah. Haley Carruthers, your designated player for the Lady Cardinals. Strike 2 for Haley. Brings the count to 0-2. Here in the top of the third inning. Strike 3 swinging, and that is the 5th strikeout for Madeline Booker. Change that over to 3rd inning. Now up to bat is Ava Coley, another designated player for the Lady Cardinals. First pitch will be a ball. Brings count to 1-0 for Ava Coley. Whoa. Ball 2 is over the high and catcher. And into the net, but with no runners on base, keep it under control. Yeah, they wanted Jack to catch it back here. Third pitch will be a ball, and the range count to 3-0.
Do you think Miss Holly knows Joe and Angie?
Does Miss Holly know Joe and Angie? Joe and Angie? Joe Mama, Angie Daddy? And that's a 4-pitch walk as Ava Coley goes down to first base with one out here in the top of the third inning.
You know what burns me?
Now up to bat is Maylee Holt, your center fielder for the Lady Cardinals. And runner goes down to second, and she is safe at second. That is number 1-0 count here in pitch, and it is a strike. That evens the count to 1-1. For Stella. Second strike here brings count to 1-2.
Did you know her daddy used to coach at Tisch County?
Did it?
Coached at Casu, New Site, played for New Site.
And that will be strike three, and another strikeout for Madeline Booker.
Played on.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 strikeouts through.
Did you hear that? Her daddy played on about 3 or 4 state champions.
Man.
And one of them was Grand Slam, if not more.
Foul down the first base side. I'll bring the count to 0-1.
Hey, I bet he wishes they'd had a three-pointer. Them shots in the corner of us. He could knock the bottom out of it anywhere but that corner.
Yeah, Madeline Booker here on the mound for the Lady Braves. With an 0-1 count and two outs here in the top of the third inning. That pitch is a ball, is down and low, and the runner advances over to third. I believe that is Ava Coley standing up on third there. As Cardinals try to score their first run of the game. 1-1 count with two outs. Pitch thrown, that is a strike. 1-2 is now the count. Pitch inside, evens it up, 2-2. Hit up the middle, over fielded by the second baseman, and over the first, and that will be an out, and the third out as we move into the bottom of the third inning. As now, through three innings of work, Madeline Booker has pitched 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 strikeouts through three innings.
That's awesome.
She's putting in the work there on the mound today. As the Lady Braves lead 5-0 as we head towards the bottom of the third inning. Happy Hollow Outdoors. We carry a large variety of gifts, seasonal gifts, baby gifts, items for women's boutique clothing, interior items. We will have a bridal and baby gift registry. In the sporting goods section, we offer camo and hunting apparel, guns and ammo, about any caliber and configuration you would want. We have supplies for baseball, softball, football, and a huge golf section with apparel and even 2 golf simulators to check your swing. Store hours open daily Monday through Saturday, 9 to 6, closed on Sunday, open on Wednesday, 9 to 5, located in Red Bay. Tracy Arnold, your District 3 House of Representatives, says good luck to the Belmont Cardinals. Looking forward to working with the great folks in the Belmont area. Want top-notch internet, no matter where you live in Tishomingo County? Tishomingo Connect is here for you. Call now at 662-423-3646 for details. Good luck to our Tishomingo County teams from Tishomingo Direct. Pro finishes, Highway 25 South in Belmont, 256-224-8447. Ricky McGee, free estimates. We specialize in RV repair and detail. We do collision repair, paint repair, scratch repair, true toppers, insurance welcome, all major credit cards. We are your RV collision center. Tonight's broadcast is sponsored by personal injury attorney Casey Lott, owner of the largest personal injury firm in Northeast Mississippi, with attorneys licensed in Mississippi, Alabama, and Tennessee. Casey and his team of attorneys specialize in personal injury, pharmaceutical, product liability cases. Call Casey for your legal needs, 662 662- 554 4000. Southeast Surplus, Edwin Boldy, 454-7484, located on Highway 25 South in Belmont, has been your Steel Power Products headquarters for 18 years. We have a huge selection of steel power tools at the lowest price around. We don't just sell it, we service it. All your steel products. Also, we are your truck accessory and car supply headquarters. We install what we sell. We have auto chemicals, chainsaws, blowers, trimmers, and outdoor power equipment. Call Edwin Boulding and the staff today, 454-7484. Napa on 97 Main Street in Belmont, 662-454-9754. We're locally owned with experienced employees. Bill Byram and staff say, good luck, Cardinals. Good luck to the Cardinals from Stacy Stepp, your 5th District Tishomingo County School Board member. Redmont Pharmacy, J.C. Weeks. Come see J.C. Weeks and our friendly staff at 356-9000.
Now batting number one, Kaylee Latch.
Now up to bat for your Lady Braves is Kaylee Latch. One is a strike. 0-1 here as the Lady Braves lead 5-0 in the bottom of the third inning. The pitch will even the count to 1-1. For Kaylee Latch. This new pitcher is number 24. That's Atlee Scott for your Lady Cardinals. Brings count to 2-1 for Latch. As the Lady Braves lead 5-0 with no outs here in the bottom of the third inning. Pitches inside. Latch works her way to a hitter's count, is what we call it. That's a 3-1 count. And that will be a walk for Latch.
Now to bat.
She goes down to first base.
Chloe Cook.
Next up to bat will be your shortstop, Chloe Cook, for the Lady Braves. First pitch is a ball, and Kaylee will move on down to second. That'll be a steal for Kaylee. She's pretty swift around the base path there.
She's pretty weak lifting, though, isn't she?
Oh, yeah.
Tell them what that young lady is.
Yeah. That's a swing and a miss for Chloe Cook. There's Kaylee Latch standing over on third base, your individual powerlifting state champion for the Tishomingo County Lady Braves. 2 years in a row. 2 years in a row. 1-1's the count for Cook. As the pitch, that one's hit. And past the shortstop into the left field. As Cook's standing up on first. She goes over to second on error. As Latch
now
scores another run
for
the Lady Braves, making the score 6-0 now. With Cook standing up on second base. Out to bat is your catcher, Emma Glover. She shows bunt, pulls it back, and foul down the third base side. Brings count to 0-1 with no outs here in the bottom of the third inning. This is JV softball action between your Tishomingo County Lady Braves and Belmont Lady Cardinals. Earlier today, we had varsity action where the Lady Braves took the win 2-0, and that ball is fouled down the third base side. Brings count to 0-2 for your catcher, Emma Glover. And Atlee Scott on the mound for the Lady Cardinals. And the pitch, and it is hit into left field and is caught by the left fielder. That will be one out for the Lady Braves. Cook remains at second.
Now batting number 10, Madison Daly.
Next up to bat will be number 10, Madison Daly. Playing over second base today for the Lady Braves. She takes plate with a runner on second and a 6-0 lead with one out. And pitch, first pitch is a ball. Second pitch is a ball. 2-0 count for Daly, your second baseman. Have Chloe Cook standing up on second with one out here in the bottom of the third inning. She hits that ball into the gap between center and left field. And Cook scores, and that will be ace. Throw goes wide, and that is an inside the park home run for Madison Daly. She scores two runs and gives the Braves an 8-0 lead here in the bottom of the third inning. Inside the park home run. We don't see a whole lot of those, Jack. It's a big hit for the freshman. Big hit for the freshman. Now up to bat, number 21, Ansley Robertson. She was on the opposite side of this rivalry last year.
Got to have Holly speed to do that.
Yeah.
Right? Did you have that much speed? She can play some basketball. Good at what?
There's strike one. It evens the count to 1-1 with one out for Ansley Robertson, your first baseman. It's an 8-0 lead here for the Braves in the bottom of the third inning. Pitch is high. Brings the count to 2-1. And she swung, and that will even the count to 2-2 with one out for Ansley Robertson. Atlee Scott here on the mound looking to get a strikeout for the Lady Cardinals. And that'll be there. Is hit to the pitcher and to the first base. First baseman, that will be their second out of the inning.
Next up to bat, number 17, Madeline Booker.
Now up to bat for the Lady Braves is Madeline Booker, your pitcher for today for the Lady Braves, who, as it sits, currently has 7 strikeouts through 3 innings of work. The pitch is hit, fielded by the first baseman, over, and that will be the third out for the Cardinals. Wildflowers, unique flowers, and gifts in Belmont. Missy and Dusty Brandon, owners located at 106 Main Street in Belmont. If you're planning a wedding in the future, come by and see us. We can make your wedding dreams come true at any budget. Send someone a little pick-me, Amy and her girls, for all your personalization, baby, school, spirit, or gifting needs. Located in Golden, Mississippi on Redbud Road. Give them a call at 662-454-1061. You can follow them on Facebook and Instagram, and be sure to check out the Madeline Booker still on the mound as the ball is fouled back behind the backstop. Brings the count to 0-1.